In the previous video, we derived a general formula for the gravitational potential energy between two point masses. So that's given by this function up here. We used the symbol capital U for the gravitational potential energy, and it turned out to be negative GMM over R, where that big G is the universal gravitational constant, the two point masses are big M and little m, and R is the center-to-center separation distance. Now in this video, we treat big M as the Earth, or any other planet you like, and we're going to derive this more familiar expression for the gravitational potential energy. That's M little g y, where y is the height above the surface of the planet, little g is the acceleration of the gravity near the surface of the planet, and little m, of course, is the mass that's interacting with the mass of the planet. And this formula is based on the approximation that our little mass m always stays very near the surface of the planet. So before we get into the meat of the derivation, we have to derive an expression for the acceleration induced by gravity near the surface of the planet. And this goes back to Newton's law of gravitation. So Newton's law of gravitation says that the force of gravity between two masses is gmm over r squared, where the big m and the little m are the size of the two masses. Big G again is the universal gravitational constant, and R again is the center-to-center separation distance between those masses. So if we just do this little experiment where we lift our little mass m, a height of y above the surface of the planet, and we just release it from rest and watch it accelerate, we can calculate the size of that acceleration, and that gives us little g. Now I do want to note that in the picture, the height above the surface is wildly exaggerated. So even Mount Everest on the surface of the Earth would be an undetectable blip compared to just the curvature of the surface. But we had to exaggerate it to make it visible for the derivation. So what we're going to do is release this mass from rest and apply Newton's second law. So I'll just start from the beginning on that. We're just going to say F net equals ma. And the net force on this little mass is given by Newton's law of gravitation. So we have G times the size of both masses divided by the separation distance between them squared. And the separation distance between these two masses is the radius of the Earth plus the height above the surface of the Earth, and we have to square that. Now this is the first place our approximation comes into play. If this mass is very close to the surface of the Earth, then that y is negligible. So it's making a negligible percentage correction to the distance between little m and the center of the Earth. All right, on the right-hand side of Newton's law, we have ma. So we have the size of our mass, little m, times its acceleration, but we have a special symbol for that. The acceleration induced by gravity near the surface of the Earth, we call that little g. Now the little m's are going to cancel out, and we have an expression for g. So the acceleration due to gravity turns out to be big g times the mass of the planet divided by the radius of the planet, Earth in this case, squared. So we're going to use that expression toward the end of our derivation. Now we get into the main part of our derivation. So we're trying to find the potential energy function in the approximation that our mass stays very close to the surface of the Earth, starting from this more general expression for the potential energy between two point masses. And to get this done, we're going to look at a process. So we're lifting our little mass m from an initial height of y1 above the surface to a final height of y2 above the surface, and we want to look at the change in potential energy. And again, we're going to apply this approximation that the mass always stays very close to the surface of the Earth. And then our change in potential energy should boil down to a nice little formula, and we'll be able to infer an expression for the gravitational potential energy at a height of y above the surface from that change. So to get started, I'll say delta U, so the change in potential energy during this process, is going to be U at the final position. And this U is a function of R, the center-to-center separation distance. So I look at my final separation distance, that's radius of the Earth plus Y2, and then subtract from that U of R Earth plus Y1. So now we just plug into our formula for the gravitational potential energy between two point masses. And when I evaluate this at R Earth plus Y2, that gives me negative G big M little m over R Earth plus Y2. Now a similar thing happens for the initial potential energy. Notice there's a minus sign in front of that, but there's a minus sign in front of the potential energy function. So I end up with a plus big G big M little m over R Earth plus Y1. And there's a couple things we want to do with this expression. First, I'm going to factor out a g big M little m. Next, I want to get a common denominator on these two fractions and go ahead and add them together. So that means I'm multiplying the first one by r earth plus y1 over r earth plus y1, and the second one by r earth plus y2 over r earth plus y2. That gives us a common denominator that's a product of the two original denominators. And then in my first fraction in the numerator, I'm going to have an r earth plus y1. In my second fraction, an r earth plus y2. And again, it's all divided by the product of those two original denominators, r earth plus y2 multiplied by r earth plus y1. So what I notice in the numerator when I distribute this minus sign is I end up with a negative r earth plus r earth. So those cancel out. And that numerator is going to simplify to y2 minus y1. And now in the denominator, this is our moment to use the approximation that our mass always stays very near to the surface of the Earth. R Earth plus Y2, a good approximation for that is just R Earth. And R Earth plus Y1, again, a good approximation for that is just R Earth. So I end up with R Earth squared in the denominator. Now what I notice is I have big G, big M over R Earth squared, but that's little g. That's the acceleration of gravity near the surface of the Earth. So I can just collapse that into a single little g, and I end up with little m little g times y2 minus y1. Finally, I can express that as mg y2 minus mg y1. And again, what we were deriving here is a change in potential energy. As I lift this little m from a height of y1 to a height of y2, so the expression we're looking at here is u2 minus u1. It's our change in potential energy, and that implicitly defines a potential energy function. It must be mgy, so that my final one is mgy2, and my initial one is mgy1. So, provided we stay very close to the surface of the Earth, and keeping in mind that the top of Mount Everest is still pretty close to the surface of the Earth, we arrive at this simple formula for gravitational potential energy. It's probably the one you were first introduced to, that it's just mgy, where y is the height relative to some origin chosen for the vertical coordinate. And we're done.
If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.